Hey y'all, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. My name's Johnny on the trail.
Hello, today, I'm Melissa.
Today my sister Melissa's here.
Yay!
And we have forged the very cold. If you see my camera shaking, it's because I'm freezing to death. It's like 32, 34 degrees.
We just boat shuttled across the lake to right here, and we're froze.
So we're gonna jet up to campsite 90, on over to Eagle Creek, and then straight up Eagle Creek, and then down boat, and down lead.
Yep, end our day.
That'd be that's a day hike for us.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, well, thanks for watching.
Bye.
Let's go hiking. All right, in 8.7 miles, we'll be at Spence Field. I might add 8.7 plus 20 plus creek crossings. And who knows how long it's gonna take us going up it. But we're gonna do it.
More to the picture.
All right, right here's our first creek crossing of Eagle Creek. So.
Time to get wet.
Can't really rock off this. So, no time like the present.
That was cold.
All right, sis, how was your first creek crossing?
About mid-thigh deep, cold.
Whew.
Yeah, that was cold.
Some stinging going on.
Woo, I gotta move.
One down to about 19 or so.
18 more. I just felt like...
Hold on. What's that, sis?
I was just saying, you know, we've had a lot of rain here lately. This was a very spontaneous planned hike. I've kind of been waiting on this trail for a couple weeks, and we had 2 weeks of very little rain, and this today was my window to come out and get it done. So kind of quickly put the plans together in motion, and here we are.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous day. Oh my gosh.
Yep.
This is beautiful. Beautiful day for sure. Every day in the Smokies is beautiful.
Absolutely.
Creek crossing number 2. Here's creek 3.
Sister Tim, Johnny Brown. Then the moon fade away. King has gone, not forgotten. So this is water crossing number 6 here on Eagle Creek. And how far have we gone? About
a couple miles, maybe two and a half, two. We've got about six and a half more to get to Spence Field.
And this one looks a little deeper than the last two. The first three were a little deep, but the last two weren't bad. So here we go, number 6.
All right, check it out.
Hey.
Man, my feet are freezing. Oh my goodness. Good thing is though, in between creek crossings, hiking up this trail gives our feet an opportunity to warm up a little bit, which is good. Not a bad trail. All right, so that was number 8. Water, look at my pants right here. There's the depth of that creek right here. I think that was the deepest one. I think that was deeper than one.
That was number 8, and I'm wet up to here. My butt cheek, my underwear. Yeah, I'm wet up to about right here. That one was cold. That was deep.
All right, we just crossed creek number 12, or crossing number 12. Just a beautiful day. I'm just so amazed by this.
Great day to be out here.
It is. You know, one thing, I may not record every single hike that I do, because I do like to just unplug sometimes and get away. All right, what I'm trying to say is, when I'm out hiking, sometimes I can't express the way I feel about the trail or being here, but man, I've got an adventurous heart. Love it so much. Hang on, I'm in beginner's tree. And so I create YouTube videos, and I do that to express my creativity. It complements our hike. And I know that there's people out there that aren't going to get out here and do the trails that I'm doing or the distance that I'm doing. And this gives them an opportunity to feel like they're right there with me. So, you know, I kind of consider them my video trail family. And I love it, and I love the encouragement I get from it. And I certainly hope that my hiking and backpacking and all that's inspiring to the viewers as well. That's the reason I do it. But like I said though, I may not record every single hike. I may take a little bit of a break. Hey sis, what creek crossing number is this?
Number 20.
Number 20.
20.
All right guys, so it's, I don't know, a little after 12 probably. We've got about a little over a mile, maybe a mile and a half to go to get to Spence Field. So we've decided to stop here, eat a little bit and fill up before we hit the hard part of the climb, which is right up that way. Hey guys, time for me to get real with you guys for a minute. Last year I did an awful lot of hiking, did some crazy high miles, love that kind of stuff. I've always been an endurance athlete. But I had came up on a case of plantar fasciitis last year, and we hiked Hazel Creek last year, and toward the end of the hike, it's a pretty good long 20-ish mile hike. Towards the end of the hike, my foot was in so much pain that I was literally crying. I was just in tears. I was just struggling to finish that one. And from my years as a runner and having a running coach and all that stuff, you know, I learned how to listen to my body and respond to what it tells me. And so this winter, I really took a lot of time off from hiking just to rest my foot. So I didn't do a whole lot of high mileage this winter because I wanted to give my foot a break. And I've done a couple longer trips already, and the issue that I was having appears to be gone, or partially gone. It's certainly manageable now, where last fall it wasn't. It was horrible. So I'm really looking forward to, I don't want to get out here this year and re-injure anything, but I'm definitely going to get out here this year and drop out some more 30, 40 mile days and some other crazy stuff. I'm also going to work on some running again. Let me know in the comments below if you've suffered with PF and how long it took you to recover and what you did, what you didn't do. But I think for me, time, rest, exercise, working it out was my keys that worked it all out for me. So today we're doing Eagle Creek and taking a quick stop up to Rocky Top and then on down Lead Cove. So it's gonna be a fairly long day today. And right now my foot's absolutely fine. Of course, this cold water's is numbing it. So, but no, my foot feels fine. There's no issues with my foot right now, thankfully. So anyway, I'm gonna get back over here and eat some more before I head up the mountain. This is finally hot. She took her jacket off. I'm already in shorts.
And I'm finally
getting
hot.
That's true. Ow, right in my ear. This is the fun part of the trail. Some of the steeper part. It's hot today. But it sure is pretty out here.
Hi guys. So we are about a mile from the AT. Straight up that. This is the part that I heard was really hard. The last mile up. Grown men have told me they have wanted to lay on the trail and cry. So here we are. It's hot.
Very hot.
We're burning. We were cold earlier, or at least I was, and now that the sun is out and it's warmer and we're climbing, it's hot.
Mm-hmm.
But it's good. Good day.
All right, we're less than 3/10 from Spence Field. Been climbing for what, about 2 miles?
Straight up for 2 miles.
Straight up, yeah. So.
I'm talking straight up.
We're almost there.
Yep.
But I think we're going to take a detour since we've hiked so much. So
it's a beautiful day.
It's a gorgeous day.
We're gonna go out to Rocky Top.
Absolutely.
See some views, have a snack.
See where we started.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Boy, that's the reward today.
It sure is. All right, let's get to Spence Field. Radio Creek is done.
All right. Did it.
One more trail.
One
more
left.
Trail. All right. We are headed to the AT. Spence Field is pretty. The blue sky. Wow. Can't believe, as warm as it is today, that there's still snow laying right here behind me. My goodness. All right, so we've just come off Rocky Top. My goodness, what a beautiful day. So beautiful up there.
Prettiest time. I've been to Rocky Top. Today was my third time, and this was the first time I've seen it like that.
Yeah.
The last two times were cloudy and fogged in, so I got an amazing view today. Mm-hmm. Had some snacks up there, water, talked to some AT hikers, and beautiful view.
You can see Bull Run Plant over in Oak Ridge. You can see Maryville, Knoxville real well. Looking
Montana.
Back this way, you can see the marina from up there.
From where we just came.
Oh my goodness, it's so beautiful. But anyway, we're here on boat. We're going to jump down Lead Cove.
Finish this day
and
out.
And end the day out. So we should be somewhere around 20.
Probably so.
You know? So anyway, hey, remember, live free, hike often, make every day great.
Sometimes it's just stuff that don't work.